1919, the year when the British arrived, there were only 20 Gambia plantations in Singapore, run by Chinese and Malays.
However, this soon started to change drastically in the 1830s, when the British dyeing and tanning industry started to create a demand for Gambia.
Gambia prices skyrocketed, which in turn boosted the opening of new plantations by the Chinese, who occupied and cleared the land mercilessly.
1836. Gambia production further increased after a group of enthusiasts, mainly Europeans, started to experiment with growing crops in Singapore and found that Gambia and pepper had an interdependent relationship.
Gambia maize and boiled Gambia leaves provided an essential fertilizer for pepper plants, while pepper leaves provided support for Gambia plants to grow.
In the late 1840s, there were 600 Gambia and pepper plantations under cultivation, employing some 6,000 Chinese laborers. This marked the start of the boom in Gambia planting.
In the late 18th century, Gambia had already spread through Singapore like a wildfire. Gambia was prevalent and more common than any other type of plant in Singapore, and the profits owners got from it were breathtaking.
However, it has smelted into an actual wildfire, wreaking havoc on many of Singapore's forests. The process of manufacturing Gambia required a lot of firewood. This meant the deaths of many trees.
Forests were cleared, much natural vegetation disappeared, and habitats of tigers were no more. Barely anything was left.
The pitiful tigers had no place to stay, no food to eat. They were out cold and starving. One idea popped up into their minds. Revenge.
One idea unanimously united them. To devour humans. Since they had gotten rid of every bit of the tiger's needs, they should get rid of every bit of them. Soon enough, they began loitering around on a feeding spree.
This could not be the way. As an act of self-defense, the government of Singapore launched a campaign. For every tiger killed, a large sum of $100 would be rewarded to them. Soon enough, people began hunting for tigers, and the tiger population dwindled drastically.
And that is how so many species of tigers are critically endangered or extinct to this day.